Hey everybody, welcome back to Xanadu next. Alright. Let's go see. We got 6 points from a level up. Let's go see what we can accomplish. So I need 2 strength for a longsword. I can buy that now. And I need 1 reflex and 4 for the Nameless Sword, which is two-handed but has a one-handed skill. This I eventually need to get. So if I get 18 I can get 18 reflexes. So I can get I can get 18 reflex and 26 strength. We'll buy this for now. And then, let's see, oh, what time is it? 11:27? There was a statue that could give me a guardian level. Chance for a better item. Since the boss door was jammed from inside the room, means I have to go the long way. Open helm. What's that? Curse defense. What's the description on it? What's this at? 25? Cool. A helmet that covers the entire head but doesn't obstruct vision. Resistant to curses. Oh. Enough that just happened to level up just in the nick of time. Sweet. Like I said, the only reason I'm going this long route for here is because... Oh! Well, I forgot that I already used that. My bad. Oops. Okay, well, I screwed up. My bad. I forgot that I used that. On the bright side, though, we got stuff. Okay, so... Anything. goddamn forest mazes. Fuck that up. Oops. That was the wrong button. Alright, so I gotta try to... I don't even know what the fuck's supposed to be in here.
Thank you. Fucking hell. Okay. Fucking Christ on a goddamn... fucking ice lizards. Ice lizards eating all the dick. Lizard man. Forgot about that. Mm-hmm. go there.
Fuck you guys. Yeah, we tried going down. No, fuck, it was up. Shit! Lightning one is a little counter-fucking productive right now. God damn it, didn't mean to press that. What's this? There's a statue of similar craftsmanship in the
place we met before. This has the same level of detail, it seems. If I had had a way to take this back, it'd fetch a nice sum. Say, what's your interest in Castle Strange Rock, anyway? I suppose as a knight, you just want to obtain the sacred sword, no? Come now, since we're partners, surely you can confide in me. What about me? I've got my reasons.
Super useful knife. The bone. I already have a. Don't I already have one? Superior.
My main purpose is actually... I'd better not say.
Ernest looking statue seems to be holding its hands in prayer. When you equip the wing boots, you'll be able to walk in the air for a short time. Just jump off while you have these equipped. That's just mean. Attack that.
fuck's sake!
Is this actually a town? It kind of seems so. Hello, bug. Some things are just fucking blocked off. Cool, you can carve two keys on a single bone this far. Mm-hmm. fuck this guy before we fight him. I am going to take my happy ass back to... Polog gotta go turn in this tablet. See if Polog can get some fucking free lunches. Although I do think... No, I think I read all of them. But fuck it. Oh. See, lately the people downstairs at the bar have been just the friendliest. The nicest person there is Dusty, though. But I kind of wonder what is such a nice guy like him is doing in the bar at all. Alright. 10th day of the Wild Rabbit's Moon, year 1212. My sister collapsed. She's always been poor of health, and I suppose time has been taking its toll. Our magic lesson was particularly rigorous, and she fainted. She's currently resting, but her face is still so very pale. My sister is constantly worrying about me, and goes about her life with a smile, showing no concern for her own troubles. I want to make sure she doesn't push herself too much, so I really must endeavor to do better. No matter how many times I've asked Father and Sage Theobald, they never seem to let her rest. Yet, if she continues like this, there has to be something I can do for her. Tomorrow, I'm planning on giving things my all so I can surpass my sister. If I can do that, then surely. Macking on my orphan sister. Hey, Knight. I gotta say, Char's a nice gal. Whenever I see her, my face just turns as red as Alcott's cherry brandy.
Miss Char is quite tough for such an adorable girl. When I see her lugging a huge pack of hers, I just want to drop everything and give her a hand. Oh, but I'm getting off track. I had something I wanted to tell you, Sir Knight. Dusty's taking quite a liking to Miss Char. Even he's not immune to her charms, it seems. For now, Miss Char has given him some errands to run about town.
Youngin, heed me well! When you can't beat a foe, take a good look at your own attributes. Luckily, Lady Leash of the Spirit Sanctum is quite talented in that area. There are times when you want to adjust your attributes, and even times when you want to knock yourself down a notch. Going that way might even turn out to be a shortcut. Well, well, that Char girl sure is something. She's been talking about all this research she's doing to be an Academy Honor student and stuff. Ain't that a thing? She's quite a charmer, too. I'd love to have a daughter like her. Alright. Okay, got a few minutes to... Chimera demon, or... Ow. Fuck off. Gonna fucking hinder me.
watch. I'm gonna need it.
Wait, where the fuck am I?
Is it the I see approaching?
If you would have made it this far, it would seem your skills have grown.
Why are we over a bottomless pit?
This is fortuitous, Knight. I have something of which I wish to say. Regarding the actions which brought the to death's edge, I wish to express my utmost regret. Swordsmen such as us need to give our all, else we risk being unable to win. If one is strong, they win. Weak, they lose. The timid do not last in our world. Thy hesitation brought about your fall. That is all there is to it. Should thy resolve waver anew, I shall cut you down countless times. Even were it not me, someone else would mete out your defeat. If thee wish to claim thyself a knight, live and show me the valor of your words. If you prove unable to do so, then cast aside the title of knight.
Actually, I think I'm a swashbuckler right now. Now I'm a myrmidon. Now we're back at the Eaglet Mountain.
Actually, I think we got just enough time to go read that tablet.
I need a level up so I can buy that new sword. The last sword they got.
The Princess Naruto.
If the literature of this era rings true, then the fair Princess Fleurette was a young lady of the most cheerful disposition, unmatched in both academic and military talent, and beloved by all her people. But though it is an incontrovertible fact that she inherited the title of Sacred Maiden at the time of her 16th birthday, little detail is known of her life before that day. Of course, the question most pertinent to these records is that of her whereabouts when she and the seven sages vanished from Xanadu. The following account is one that may prove most familiar to my readers, as it endures to this very day in the canon of tales recounted to Oriana. Regrettably, there exists no official report of these events, so all information herein pertaining to Princess Florence's emprise is comprised from hearsay and rumor of the time. The last confirmed location of Princess Fleurette and her party was in the vicinity of Lindale. With the dragon slayer shimmering in her hands, our noble heroine had her sights set upon the mysterious castle that appeared only amidst the fog and the water. The selfsame fort that had eluded the prior frenzied search of Xanadu's army, Castle Strange Rock, stronghold of Galsis. The princess and the seven sages, having successfully infiltrated the elusive citadel, had thus set about tracking down the devil and his bride therein. And in those haunted halls, to behold the mere shadow of the princess wielding the sacred sword was as if to see the guardian Valkyria herself. Such was the level of mastery displayed by our heroine. At long last, after 7 days of fierce battle, Princess Fleurette's holy blade was plunged through the massive neck of the Dragon King. The Black Bride, with her husband dead and her power lost, is said to have then relinquished Castle Strange Rock into the waters deep and herself to eternal sleep. Of course, this is all little more than folktale. Whatever truth there may be to this grandiose epic has been lost in the ages. It is historical fact, however, that the incursions wrought by the Devil's Minion suddenly ceased no more than a single month after Princess Floret's disappearance from Xanadu, and since that time, neither Scale nor Claw has been seen of Galsis or his bride. Now, the princess is heralded as one of the great figures of our time, a savior regarded with reverence and admiration akin to that bestowed upon the founder himself, the great Kublai Khan. And after these events, no further incidents occurred, leaving Xanadu's record books with naught but peace and prosperity to this very day. I must admit that even I, typically unaffected as I am by the march of time that I commit to record, had become enamored of all this lore. When I call to mind the image of Princess Floret brandishing her holy blade, I find myself lost in the moment.
Seems like this is talking about Princess Floret, which I'm probably not pronouncing correctly. She must have looked amazing wielding the sacred sword against Galsis. And then there's the mention of Castle Strangerock. It might just be a clue. But I guess we can't be certain if the rumors from that era are true. It says the Black Bride sunk it into the lake. Oh, before I forgot, I made lunch! Hope you like it. I put a lot of work into it this time.
Heard your experience.
Alright, so what did you make for me this time?
A bountiful collection of freshly sliced seasonal fruit.
Well then. Thing is, I'll keep him on because it might be affecting the experience more than I know. Something kind of tells me no, but anyway, I'll catch you guys next time. Adios.